Who's ready to never leave Immortal Battlefield again? Me, I'm ready. There's just too many things in it. It's like an entire game in and of itself. But we did get to see at least a little bit of the Niflheim. We gotta do some stuff in there. We gotta do some stuff everywhere. We gotta flood this place, because it needs to be. Just to get rid of it. We need to go to the Niflheim. We need to get things there. There's mantras to find. Gate of the Dead still has that white pedestal puzzle we didn't do anything with. There's too many things! There's curry stank all over! Ah! I wonder who's to blame for all this. Not me. I didn't leave the curry stank there. In fact, it's probably rotting by now. How long has it been in this game? Like, in game time. Not like my playtime or real life. I just want to know, like, how many hours has Lamisa been here right now? And she's already changed costumes twice. Anyway, Immortal Battlefield. We still got more things to do in here. Even Mulbrick isn't done yet. We have to open the floodgates. Then it'll be waterlocked, and the Yggdrasil's roots will get some much-needed water, I guess. Also, that Jormungand. So, let's just open the floodgates. Everything's going to die now. I didn't see the water level change. This physics is all messed up. Ah! There's thing down there. I see a glossary. I'm gonna have to go around the curry stank way. I think it's this way. No, it's not. And that pot had nothing in it. Yeah, if there's only an easier way to get past the werewolves. But no, the werewolves are indeed werewolves. So we got waterfall now. It's making Mulbrick sleepy. Ah, ain't she cute? When she's not getting in trouble. She's going to eat the cheese puff guy. Actually, you could randomly see the cheese puff guy hanging out in her tent. You don't see him right now. Probably heard what she was saying. Wonder if she has anything else to say about food. Ah, that's oddly specific. I'll respect her wishes. Maybe if we find more crystal skulls, she'll do more things for us. I think 5 is the threshold, and we got 4. So I'm gonna have to find another crystal skull somewhere. I'm gonna avoid the trap this time. Avoid the curry stank. Because I need to get that glossary. Ugh, it's so hard to swim when you're buoyant. You need to fix that too. That's in the Gate of the Dead as well. But at least I got the Cetus data. What does it say about Cetus? It's a dolphin dog. Well, he died by spears. He's no longer dolphin or dog. Now this area is flooded. Well, at least the bottom part of this area. Which means new things have opened up for us. Also, I could grapple claw whenever I want. You don't need a helmet in this game. She's better at Lamisa at that, anyway. But we could sigil. And that'll open... Ah, chest! I didn't even see the chest on the screen at first. Kraken gets out of my way. And we get the sacred orb! For the Immortal Battlefield! That cheese puff guy's gotta die, I gotta feed him the Mulbrick. 2 sigils hidden by falling water. Check the back of the three-eyed waterfall. I think that has to do with, Ice Cloak, which I've gotten. Well, we can finally get to this thing. It's a prophecy tablet! Part 1! Man, these are way out of order. Heimdall blows his horn, the tree shakes, things start going bonkers! It's time for crazy Norse apocalypse! So, I have to save that. That's important. That's very important. I'm gonna have to move that to where all the other prophecies are. We got part 1, 2, and 3 now. I almost forgot how you move these things. Here we go. The prophecy is prophesizing something. And this is the Jormungand's room again. We need to raise a Jormungand. Sometime today. There we go. It has been risen! The Kraken is angry! Attacks are slower when you're floating in water. Well, at least when you're sinking in water, like in the water itself. If you're at the top, your weapon is fine. But I want to get over here. Those who have Mjolnir can possess lightning. You just need to raise the hammer. Well, I would like a Mjolnir, but there's some things I need to do before I can hold Mjolnir, before I am worthy. And then we'll have, what, the fourth Thor movie. Here's King Yama of the Underworld. The Underworld is the endgame area. Hell lives in there. Like, literally, her name is Hell. Okay, someone's gonna have to help me out with that one. I can't translate that. He knows some things about the Underworld, though, clearly. Alright, not right now, though. But at least he got his glossary data. King Yama of the Lokapala. So if we just kill him, the Lokapala are done for, right? Well, he's been cast out of the Underworld. Hell took his place, apparently. That's what I'm getting from all that. So we raised the Jormungand, but we still need some things. We need many, many more things. Also, don't get crushed! Yeah! Yeah! It's like Palenque all over again! I'm getting Palenque vibes! That was close! It almost murdered me too, Phobos. Some sort of vehicle. It's holding a key for a vehicle. It's a golden key. So I'm gonna have to find a golden key. I think that's in Frost Giants. I'm still busy going through all this mess. Alright, now that the water is flowing, some machinery will be operational. And that's down below where we got the chain rent. That should be able to take us somewhere. There's Large Man again. I forgot I read him. Can't tell where the spikes are, but we're going this way. Hey, it's those guys! Hey! Get back here! Ah. They're out exploring where I can't reach. This area down here is all blocked off. You have to go somewhere else to get there. Unfortunately, Lameza and Shorn have already found their way there. Also, there's another totem pole here in case you need 3 warp points in this area. Also, mashers! Do not get mashed! It's not the Lameza mash. Oh, Bruta the tourist! He got mashed. Don't be like him. Don't get mashed, especially not twice. Just carve up some cheese balls. Serve them to Mulbrook. She'll love them. Yeah, that's the grapple claw hint. We got it. We got it, like, super early. Like, video 3 or something like that. Because I like breaking sequences when it comes to La Mulana games. Okay, that chest we can't really get to yet. But at least we have the life sigil. Can't get there until later. A lot later. Also, we can't even make this jump anymore. I don't even think there's anything else in here that's of importance. No. I kind of just, like, fail-cornered myself, I believe. Is there a breakable wall down here? No. Also, we can't get out of this pit once we get in it. I'm gonna have to teleport back. So, let's see. We got that out of the way. We at least opened that. Isn't there some Lameza papers over there, too? He was doing research and left them in, like, a cavern. Giant, wide-open pit. Kind of reminded him of Chamber of the Birth, the Infinity Hole. Anyone remember the Infinity Hole from Chamber of the Birth? That place sucked. Luckily, I only got caught in it once. It's easy to get caught in it multiple times. But that's why I brought along Heal Fairy, in case I get caught in it. Fortunately, it's not an Infinity Hole, but it's still annoying. Because you have to go around the long way. Remember when I used a shortcut to get to the spiral boat? Still can't do anything with the spiral boat, though. Yeah, there it is, the Lameza papers. I don't even know if I could get there from here. I think I go up and around? Yeah, I could go up and around. Okay, good. I was wondering how I get to that. So, Lameza papers. Let's see what he found in his research. More data. Actually, this is old data. Yeah, this is about the giants, and Sackett got blamed for the conflict. Here's the fifth children. They're the bird people we met in the Gate of the Dead. They're split between the Ennead and the Amarna. Ennead are fighting the Amarna because the Amarna wants Eglana, and also someone's chimeritizing with death weapons. The fifth children were a lot more intelligent. They had too much power though, and the mother killed them. Also, there was dwarves in this race because they were a lot smaller. She learned after the giant thing. Oh no, too much intelligence! Hubris! They were a lot older than humans, too. They had a much longer lifespan. They found ways to escape death and make life. They started fighting each other, though, and they didn't find a way to stop the war because they were still human beings. But the Tree of Life was taken by the Mother, and she started using it to create even more life. So the fifth children really didn't create the six children, they just created the means to make the six children. That's why the Mother was able to have her way until the eighth children came along. The seventh children broke the cycle. That's interesting lore. Write that down in your coffee books. Ah, three soul door. But we need to go the other way. So that's where Lameza and Shorn went. How'd they get through all those walls without the puzzles being solved? They can at least do a little bit of the work if they're going to be running around. Maybe the puzzle's just reset, like waiting for a new person to solve the puzzle. But this thing's moving now. You might want to not touch the lava. You might not want to have your jump button stick. You might need to be able to deflect projectiles, or this skeleton is going to tear you wide open. Yeah, once you get the water running, that thing is going to start Yoshiing all over the place. Let's go this way. It's the Muspelheim! We don't have a map of this area yet, but we're in the fire section. And here's a Ratatosker! What are you doing with that? Get back here! Ah. That Ein leaves me too. I'm all alone now. Great. And that's probably poison lava. I don't want to mess with that. I see skeletons. Valvolga! That's almost Volvagia. That's what I meant by feeling the burn. That was a trap. I jumped over it because I'm smarter than the average archaeologist. Which actually is quite smart because average archaeologists are, you know, got college degrees and stuff. The Vidfolnir. That's new data about an enemy, a mini boss. A small bird and a big eagle. So don't attack the powerful eagle. Ratatosker is messing about in the underworld. That's his real body. He's stealing Ankh jewels, apparently, now. Yeah, he's not happy with just the crystal skulls. He wants Ankh jewels, too. They're shiny and pretty. He has a weasel complex. And the power of Katana slays everything. You know, for being a La Mulana game, we're not doing a lot of whip work. No, it's more swordplay now. Or prophecy! Part 5. This is a big hint about something much, much later. So you can't see things with starlight, and the sun and the moon have power. Well, that needs to get saved in my coffee books. Let me just organize this a little bit. We don't have part 4 yet, though. I wonder where that's hanging out at. It's like I'm doing something out of order. Now, I see what looks like to be a shop up there. I want to get that. And then we're going to have to find a way back around because I want to go to the Niflheim next. Ah, she has an app! It's expensive as heck! Enga Musica! No! You got something on your face? You want to talk about this? So, we can't get an Enga Musica because it's way more than our gold limit. It's like we're gonna have to pull a Link and get a bigger wallet or something. But that was BTK. It was the pork item shop. So she's kinda like, what was it? Journey to the West, Chohakai? the pig demon that wants to look like a pretty guy. Oh, she has a cursed box. She has Pandora's box this entire time. She also likes to overprice her Inga Musica. So this is pretty much the northern area of... Oh, Magma. The northern area of Magma. Luckily, I have the ice cloak now. I don't even remember what's in this chest, but we're gonna get it now. Because it's here. There's enemies galore, though. Alright. Jump! Kill skeleton in midair! Ah, there's the map. There's the fire section, and the ice section is off to our right. There's a shortcut back, because the grail point is right here. But it requires lava. And you would have boiled in lava without an ice cloak, which you would have to get from the Immortal Battlefield. You'll still take damage, though, and I'm still quite floatable. So don't mess with the magma. In fact, you might want to cool yourself off in some water next. But no, it's cold. Why is it cold? There's ice in the water. So you'll get chip damage even from this, because the scale sphere is only protecting you against poison water. And not even the poison in the magma either. Well, here's the pillars they were talking about. You need the grapple claw to get across those, and they're slippery, so you might fall off. It's slippery everywhere around here. This is the Niflheim. The treasure of the dwarves! We can't defy the flow of water yet. Apparently the Inyid were knocking around in here too. That's a ladder for us, and also... Inanna. Her body's in the underworld. She's a ghost Naga. Well, that's what she gets for trying to go to the underworld while she's alive. Oh well. Anything else for us? Nope. She just tried to enter the underworld living and then she died. Because they don't like that. You're not welcome. Oh hey, secret wall. Apparently it hit my shield. I don't know. Oh, hey, it's time for some more costume changes. There's another costume box. If I remember correctly, it's this one. Anybody want a pretzel? I don't like this costume. When I was voting for costumes, I voted for Valkyrie. Because they had like a Kickstarter voting thing for which costumes are going to make it into the game. I think the other ones will be added like later in updates after they're done all their bug fixing and whatnot. I didn't like this one. Water flows from the Eye of Chaos. You know what? I'm not even quite sure what this one's supposed to be talking about. That was kind of obscure to me, too. I don't remember. But it was written by the Olympians. We haven't met any of those guys yet. I don't believe, anyway. But hey, Greek mythology. So we got that going on. Also, we got a secret shop in here somewhere. Once I take care of this Garm... the Garm just took care of himself. German Fury! Barbarian Fury! Heated waters gush with power! Surpass the body's limits and ease your pain. So what are you talking about there? Is that an advertisement for something? Because I don't know what you're advertising, I don't know what you're selling, and I don't think I want any. I'm trying to save my money here. I don't think there's anything secret here, and it looks like there's some, like, really weird quicksilver lava. There's lots of good things in this room, if you know where to look. So I can't reach that tablet up there, I need to be able to jump better. Beauty begins at the foot of you! I think I deciphered it too, but I'm not ready to do that one just yet. But we are in the Great Bird Nest. There's no birds to be seen until, you know, right now. Because there's a bird in it. There's a bird in this nest now, and he once was his. Like that sigil. I forgot to grab the sigil. Yeah, the shield thing doesn't quite work. Look at her arm. Watch her arm. She's doing the same animation, but she's holding the shield. I think that's a costume thing. Well, that lowers the statue, and that's the only way you could get up to... a different area. I don't think these vampire ladies could go through the balance floor. That's a good thing. Okay, there's two things we need to do here. First, there's a breakable wall over there. You can't can't use regular weapons because you'll fall off the balance pole. But I want to fall off the balance pole anyway. That gives us a ladder. And I think we could jump off the ladder. No, we can't jump off the ladder. I forgot. Can't do that laterally anyway. Didn't we just meet this guy? Or was that a different person? Oh no, he was mentioned on a tablet. But he knows about Underworld and Hell. Permit me. You must enter the Eternal Prison. Which means you have to defeat a bird named Vidofner. And you'll need the power of flame. So, what I need is, I need to find the person that stole the power of flame from Frey, so I could go kill a Vidofner and get to Hell. Wow, that's a long one. Surtur's wife has the power of flame, but you're gonna need a light scythe. Is this a fetch quest? Isn't there something you can do about this? I don't want a fetch quest. So speak to other people. I know a couple people that might have gone to the underworld. Well, thanks for the hint, buddy. Well, that's useful. Now we have an open chest, but I have to go back all the way around. I read that skeleton, didn't I? Yeah, he was talking about bird. He saw a bird, he saw my foot, and he was like, I got it! You're the puzzle solution! Fairy Guild Pass! Now we could buy fairies! We've only seen one fairy shop, though, and that's Weapon Fairy, and no. How about we don't? Don't need Weapon Fairy. What's she gonna do? Throw shurikens at a wall and hit me with lightning? Don't need that. Don't need that at all. I'd rather have these coins. And go right back to the Immortal Battlefield, but somewhere else. Life Sigil opens up this barrier. Now this seems like a nonsense area that leads absolutely nowhere but to like a one-way door. But you would be mistaken. There's a thing here. Right here. There used to be a hidden room off to the left, but Nigoro came back and put that room in. So people think, hey, there's something there I can't get to. How do I get to that? Well, you break walls, that's how you get to that. Cause some property damage. And it leads you to this room. This is the Moon Altar, at the very bottom of the Immortal Battlefield. There's an eye watching us. The moon rises here. Speak to that effect. That's an obscure puzzle. That's a really obscure puzzle. I would not blame you if you are confused. Also skeleton. A child 270. So take the ruin seriously, it'll cut you wide open. Get some chakrams for your effort. So, we need to speak to the effect of moon, but we can't say moon. What's the opposite of moon here? I mean, Yoro might be it, but how about we try sun? Soul! That gets us a mantra plate. Man, the mechanisms in this ruins are fantastic. Just take a picture of this, it'll last longer. The underworld spoke of a circling ring, known as the moon. Money! That's another mantra for us, the moon mantra. Now we have enough mantras to go melt some ice. Even though we don't know the proper mantra for melting ice. But I know a mantra. I heard it whispered in the shadows. Deep in a place that we've never been. Stab the dinosaur! You need a piercing weapon to get the dinosaur so you can get the dinosaur. Kill a dinosaur, get a dinosaur! I'm sure that puzzle solution is somewhere around here. That there's a dinosaur out of the way. I don't know. I just felt like stabbing the dinosaur statue, okay? I wanted a dinosaur figurine. Is there anything else? Oh, the bird's foot. Yeah, I forgot about the bird's foot. Gonna have to go back there. Luckily, there's a pillar right here that we've seen in the last video. Let's go check out that bird now. because that bird statue, it wasn't me. And that kind of upsetted me, because I wish it was me. I should have a statue in this game. God of Prosperity Ganesh! Talisman will bless you with prosperity. I wonder if that can make my wallet bigger. Because I need to buy an Anga Musica. Oh, I'm going the wrong way! Ah! Well, that looks cool. Ah, gotta check out Bird, though. Maybe we'll get back to that in a second. Alright, stare at the bird's foot. Stare at it! Look at the superiority. Any moment now. Rah. Look, talons are better than other feet, okay? You can grab with them, for one thing. There we go. I wasn't even looking at the foot. But, yeah, I wasn't close enough. I wasn't gazing at it lovingly enough. You are dog. Why are you associated with bird? Well, anyway, he has a hot spring. I kinda already filled my health. We'll check out this hot spring later. You might need it. Let's go check out that weird swinging swing things over here. Oh, how about we don't check out the weird swingy swing things because ice. I didn't stop myself in time. I should try that again. This is a lot easier if you have a double jump, because you have to line yourself up with those platforms in just the right way. I kind of want to get in there now. I'll give it one more try, and then I'm ending the video. Alright, come over here before I slide down this slope. Also, there's a vampire lady in the way, and I don't like vampire ladies being in the way. Alright, you know what? The heck with it. We'll do that another time. Maybe when I have better air control. Ah! Next time on La Mulana 2, we have fairy passes, and we gotta do a Gate of the Dead thing. It's time to go to those white pedestals, because we have all the mantras we need to open those. Good night, folks.